We want to determine the area under the given function on the interval from 1 to infinity, where the interval is closed on 1. So here's x equals 1, and we'd move to the right indefinitely to approach positive infinity. So what we're trying to determine with this question is, can we determine the area under this function even though this function never touches the x-axis as it approaches infinity to the right? But maybe this function is decreasing enough that we can actually determine the area as a finite value. Well, because this function is non-negative on this interval, we should be able to set this up as a definite integral. So the area would be equal to the definite integral from 1 to infinity of 8 divided by x to the fourth with respect to x. Now this is an improper integral, so we'll change the notation to the limit as b approaches infinity of 1 to b. So we replace infinity with b, and then we'll determine the limit as b approaches infinity of the definite integral. So I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this as 8x to the negative fourth dx, so we can find the antiderivative. So now we'll have the limit as b approaches infinity of 8 times x to the negative 4 plus 1, that's going to be negative 3 divided by negative 3. The limits of integration are from 1 to b. Let's clean this up. We have the limit as b approaches infinity. This is going to be negative 8 thirds. And then we'll have x to the third in the denominator. So we'll have the limit as b approaches infinity of, we'll have negative 8 all over 3b cubed minus negative 8 all over 3 times 1 cubed. Well, as b approaches infinity, notice how in this fraction the denominator is increasing without bound and the numerator is fixed at negative 8. So this is going to approach 0. And this is not affected by b. This is going to be minus negative 8 thirds, which will be positive 8 thirds. So this tells us that the area under this curve, bounded by the x-axis, is actually finite, and it's equal to 8 thirds square units. So you'll have to admit, it's kind of a strange concept that this function never actually touches the x-axis, but it's decreasing fast enough that we can actually determine the area as a finite value. One more thing we should mention, because this limit did exist, we can say this improper integral converges.